look so sad. I know it's so bad. But life.
Provided you sit quietly, no leaning back in your chairs, and don't fight or argue. lose your children, sit up straight, and I see no reason why we can all have a pleasant meal every evening.
Can we try it tonight, Dad?
Not tonight, Charlie, because we're playing a small dinner party, and I would like both you and Liz to come down and shake hands.
But, Daddy, I get so shy.
Oh, you just have to learn, sweetie pie. Mm-hmm. Half of life is learning how to meet people.
What's the other half, Dad?
Is that a crack?
No, Dad.
That was a wisecrack, wasn't it?
No, Dad, really.
That sounded like a wisecrack to me. And people that make wisecracks like that don't normally eat in the dining room.
I didn't mean it as a crack, Dad.
Then we'll ignore it, then.
Hey, Carl's here, Lizzie.
Yippee!
Thank you, Annie.
Thank you, Annie.
Okay, goodbye, dear.
Goodbye, Dad.
Run on now. Run.
Okay, Daddy.
Dad?
Hmm?
Can I read the comics?
Certainly you may. There you go, son. Now, this may not mean much to you, but the government is systematically ruining this country.
Mm. Miss Kelly told us about the government.
Oh, really? And who is Miss Kelly?
He's my teacher.
I don't remember a Miss Kelly.
He knew that.
I see. And what has she been telling you?
She says there's a depression going on.
I see.
People all across the country are standing in line for bread.
I see.
So the government's got to step in and do something.
Annie!
Yes, sir.
I would like some more coffee, please.
Yes, sir.
Now, Charlie, you tell Miss Kelly she's wrong.
What?
I'll tell you exactly what. If the government keeps handing out money, then no one will want to work. If no one wants to work, there'll be no one to support such things as private schools.
Mm.
And if there's no one to support private schools, then Miss Kelly, she'll be standing on the red lines with everyone else. Now, you tell Miss Kelly that. Thank you, Annie.
Dad?
Hmm?
Can we leave a little earlier this morning?
We leave when we always leave.
But I'm always late, Dad.
Nonsense.
I am. Yesterday I walked into assembly while they were still singing the hymn.
A minute or two late.
Everyone looked at me, Dad.
Well, you tell them to concentrate on that hymn.
I can't, Dad. I can't.
The new stoplight at Richmond Avenue. Must be affected out of time.
It's not just a new stoplight, Dad. Sometimes I walk in when they're already doing arithmetic. Miss Kelly says I should learn to be more punctual.
Miss Kelly again, hey.
She says everyone is late, no one would learn mathematics.
Let me tell you something, Charlie. Now, Miss Kelly may be an excellent teacher. Flattering may be flawless. But you're not going to be beyond question. But Miss Kelly cannot teach us politics, nor can she teach us how to run our lives. She cannot tell you or me to leave in the middle of this breakfast, to get caught up in the bulk of the morning traffic, so you can arrive in time for a silly hymn. Now, long after you've forgotten that hymn, long after you've forgotten how to factor, long after you've forgotten Miss Kelly, you got to remember these breakfasts at this table. Now here's your mother to prove it to you.
Good morning, dear.
Good morning.
Good morning, Charlie.
I know people will leap up to their feet when a beautiful woman enters the room.
Oh, that's all right, dear.
And I know people will push in their mother's chair.
Oh, thank you, dear.
And I know people will quake to give their mother the midsection of the morning paper.
Here, Mom.
Thank you,
good,
dear.
Good. Now, if you would, please, look at your lovely mother. Bathe in the morning sunlight reflected on this dining room table.
Oh,
look at
Russell.
Her, Charlie. Look at her. Now you need to ask yourself carefully, which should we give our ultimate attention to? Your mother or Miss Kelly?
Who's Miss Kelly?
Never mind, dear. Which, Charlie?
My mother.
Good. Now, before we say goodbye, let's take a trip upstairs, and then we're on our way.
Good
family's dining room table.
Why not?
Because it wasn't designed for it, that's why.
Oh, Howard.
Lucky I came back. Next thing you know, you'd be feeding the dog off our low-stuffed china.
Well, there are rubber pads under it, I checked. We can get something else if you want.
You're not going to use those placemats.
Yeah, I thought I would.
Those are good placemats.
But we haven't used them in 10 years.
Those are extremely good placemats, Ellie. Mother got those in Italy.
All right. I'll use these then. Mind if I use these with the pots and then certainly put a typewriter? Mama's cooking two more, Mrs. Two more? The first one stood up the plate while she was butting the toast.
Annie, is she drinking again?
No, Mrs.
Tell me the truth, Annie.
I don't think so, Mrs.
Honestly, Annie, a simple question of two poached eggs. I think if we want something done, sometimes we just have to do it ourselves.
Awfully hard to leave while your wife is systematically mutilating the dining room table.
I'll be careful, Howard. I swear to goodbye.
Could you please work somewhere else?
Well, I'd like to know where.
What's wrong with the kitchen table?
Oh, Howard, that doesn't work. Last time the kids got peanut butter all over my footnotes.
I'll set up the bridge table in the living room.
And then I would just have to move every time you and the boys wanted to watch a football game.
You mean you don't leave all that stuff there?
Yes, I thought I would.
All that shit, all over the dining room. Commandeer the dining room for the rest of the term?
It just sits here, Howard. It's never used.
Well, what if we want to give a dinner party?
Since when have we given a dinner party?
Well, what if we want to have somebody over, for Christ's sake?
Then we'll eat in the kitchen.
Oh, Jesus.
But everybody does these days.
Doesn't make it right.
Oh, Howard, please. Just let me get this done. Let me get a good grade and my master's degree and a good job so I can be out of here every day.
Fine. What the hell? Why don't I turn it into a tool room every night?
And from then on, she refused to join the workday world, darling. Now, there it is in a nutshell. You make your decision, honey, while I go order the groceries.
Stop that talk.
It's true, Ed.
And
more patience, and soon it's time for a good, easy, cooperative supper with the family.
But not in the dining room.
No, not in the dining room.
This room has such resonance.
So does the church, but it doesn't mean we have to live in it.
Ooh.
Look, I know whereof I speak. I grew up in a room like this.
Oh, yes?
Oh, sure. This is home turf to me.
Really?
Oh, God, yes. My father sat in a chair just like that one. My mother sat here.
Don't do that to me. You know what? Now go back and join the party. Sorry.
Ted, I grew up here.
You didn't?
I mean, just to pick up steaks.
I know.
I mean, I live here.
Me too. I guess we have to behave ourselves then.
Oh, Ted.
Be like good little children.
I can't stand it.
And if we sit close to each other, we have to make a conscious effort.
We won't be sitting next to each other. Judy, you'll see to that.
For a while, anyway.
Quite a while.
Oh. Hi. I finished, Mommy.
Thank you, darling.
What are you?
I'm Nick, Grant.
What do you want?
To have lunch with you.
Then you're late.
I went down to the club.
Who sat out there at the club?
My parents. My parents say you always eat there.
Lately, I've been coming home.
Yes, sir.
There are no half the people at the club anymore. Dora takes care of me, don't you, Dora?
Yes, sir.
Well, you tracked me down. That shows something. Bring him some lunch, Dora.
Yes, sir.
Thanks, Grant.
Sir, you're Nick, eh?
Yes, I am.
You're the one who wants to go to Europe this summer.
No, that's my sister Mary.
You're the one who wants the automobile. Says he can't go to college without an automobile.
No, that's Tony. That's my cousin.
And what do you want?
Oh, I really don't want anything.
Everybody who sits down with me wants something. Usually it's money. Do you want money?
Yes, sir.
For what?
My education, Grant.
Oh. Education, eh? That's a good thing, or it can be. Doesn't that can be a bad thing? Where do you want to be educated?
St. Luke's School in Litchfield, Connecticut.
Never heard of it.
An excellent boarding school for boys.
Is it Catholic?
I don't think so, Brent.
Sounds Catholic to me.
I think it's High Episcopalian, Brent.
Then it's expensive.
My parents think it's a first-rate school.
Oh, your parents think, eh?
And they discussed all the boarding schools in the area and decided that this one is the best.
They decided, eh?
Yes, sir.
And then they decided you should get your grandfather to pay for it.
Yes, sir.
Another one leaving the nest, Dora.
Yes, sir.
And taking a piece of the nest egg. Yes. Why don't you stay home?
Me?
You.
Oh, because I want to broaden myself.
You want to what?
I want to broaden my horizons. My horizons need broadening.
Mm. Well, I see.
And I'll meet interesting new friends.
Don't you have interesting friends here? up, Dora?
No, sir.
Dora doesn't think you need buffing up. I don't think you need buffing up. You'll have to think of a better reason.
Well, they've got advanced Latin there.
Uh-huh. I see, and?
And an indoor hockey rink.
I see, and?
And beautiful grounds and surroundings.
Don't we? Don't we have beautiful grounds and surroundings? Why do you have to go away from beautiful ground and surroundings?
I don't know, Grant. All I know is everyone's going away these days.
Everybody's going away. Yeah, Dora, everybody's going away.
Yes, sir.
An awful lot of people are going away, Grant.
I never went away.
I know.
Didn't even go to Country Day. Went to PS 36 down on Huron Street.
Yes, Grant.
Didn't finish either. Father died and I had to go to work.
I know that, Grant.
My father. Yes. Father didn't even go to school. He learned Greek at the plow.
Told us, Grant.
Yes, well, it didn't do me too much harm either. But have a high Episcopalian boarding school and an indoor hockey rink.
But you're a self-made man, Grant.
Oh. Is that what I am? And what are you? Don't you want to be self-made or do you want someone else to make you, huh? Huh? What do you have to say to that?
I don't know.
Everybody's going to go away.
Me?
I went away twice. Took two vacations in my entire life. First vacation, took a week off from work to marry your grandmother. I went to Hot Springs, Virginia. Bought this table. Second vacation, Europe, 1928. Again with your grandmother. Hated the place.
You, I would.
Miserable food. Oh. Took a trunkload of shredded wheat and came back when it ran out. Back to this table. They're all leaving us, Dora.
Yes, sir.
Scattering like birds.
Yes, sir.
This one wants to go to some fancy New England boarding school. Wants to go out with those guys from Philadelphia and Long Island. He'll come back speaking with marbles in his mouth. We won't understand a word. Oh, and we won't see much of him. Here go visiting in New York and Baltimore and liquor in the afternoon and get mixed up with ladies and women who wear lipstick and trousers and his only thought is the next dance. And he wants me to pay for it. Am I right?
No, Grant, no. I want to go, really. I never wanted to go. I want to stay here with all of you.
Just finish your greens. They're good for the lower intestine. You go. You've got to go. I'll send you to St. Woos's and Miss Betsy to Miss Watts's and Andy to whatever it's called. And Mary can go to Europe and Tony can have his car. It's all fine and dandy. Go on. Enjoy yourselves, all of you. Travel. See the world. Found it. Do you know I'll be sitting in this chair when you get back? I'll tell you. Some Irish fella, some big black guy will be sitting right in this chair saying the same thing to his grandson. And your grandson will be back at the plow. Which, come to think of it, won't be such a bad thing, will it, Dora?
No, sir.
Well, go on. Go on and get his checkbook before he falls asleep.
Thank you.
Well, for all this time, you've been thinking that something is terribly valuable.
Well, in a sense, it's well made. Reasonably.
Well, you'll learn something every day. Well, you sure know a lot about furniture, don't you?
I'm beginning to.
Beginning to? Oh, I bet your father was a cabinet maker or something.
No, my father was a banker.
A banker?
Yes, and I was a stockbroker until I got into this.
Oh, I don't believe it.
Oh, yes. I wanted to see what I was doing, touch it, and see the results.
Oh, I'm amazed. I mean, I know some stockbrokers. Oh, well, so is this the support that's bad?
Yes. Go on.
Oh, well, what if you were to put a nail right here?
No, not a nail, a screw.
Oh, all right, then. Well, what if you were to put another one right here, or at least some household cement?
Well,
sad and pined, I heard him sing, sing a orally. Orally, orally, made of golden hair. Sunshine came along with thee and swallows in the air.
That was absolutely lovely. I love music. Everyone in my family could play a different musical instrument.
She's coming around. Quickly, second verse.
In thy blush the rose was born, music when you spake. Through thine azure eye the morn sparkling seemed to break. Orally, orally, made of golden hair, sunshine came along with thee and swallows in the air.
Drive her down and show her everything. New office building where her house used to be, the entrance to the thruway, the new Howard Johnson's motel, everything. She'll see that there's nothing there.
I'll bring the car around.
I'll get her coat.
All right, I'll come too.
Just have to go through the motions.
Oh dear, that was scary.
I know it.
Now I suddenly feel so precarious.
No, you haven't absolved.
You know, it's almost as if we didn't even exist, as if we were all just ghosts or something. And did you see her own son? She walked right by them. You know what I could really use? Good, stiff drink.
I'm with you.
You know, I bet Mrs. Driscoll could use one, too.
I bet she could.
Let's go ask her.
Mrs. Driscoll?
Yeah, let's.
Okay. We'll go have a drink with Mrs. Driscoll, then we'll dig into this yummy turkey,
then we'll help her do the dishes, and then we'll figure out how we're going to get through the rest of this goddamn day.
At this time,
ha ha.
her mother read in the family circle that Mills Dorn, TV Dorn Mills, was bad for you. So now we just turn on the stereo and we listen to semi-classical music.
We used to go to the kitchen, but then when I got used to that boarding school, they came back here in the dining room. Supposed to give me some sense of humility or something.
Do you think it does?
Shit, no! Just makes me nervous. Take the telephone off the hook so no one can call. And then my brother gets a G about his homework. And then when my sister had anorexia, she still had to sit here and watch, for God's sake. And then my parents are nosing in the ovation, and the whole thing bites out there, bites something in here. Do you want another drink?
No, thank you.
Well, I do. You call the boys and tell them it's all clear.
Oh, you love my dining room? You love my dining room? I say it's viciously nice. Sarah!
What?
When the boys come over, we can have our drinks in here.
In the dining room?
Yeah. I mean, wouldn't it be cool sitting around this big, shiny table with Eddie and Mom's a Wayne right here? Drinking gin and Fresca and vodka?
No way! Absolutely no way! I get a little tight in here! Having boys in the dining room? Come on, Jesus, I mean, you really are a wimp sometimes.
My Oprah!
Someone with a key.
Oh, well now you've got to stay. Mom.
Oh, what happens?
Mom, now you have to have tea. Mom.
Oh, we're here, dear. Oh, darling. How did you get here?
Well, I took a cab to the bus station.
Oh, well, you look marvelous, prettier than ever. Say hello to Uncle Gordon.
Hi, Christina.
What's this? Is this what they teach you at boarding school? Not to shake hands, not to call people by name?
know, you can learn a lot about a culture from how it eats.
Such as what?
Well, take the finger bowls, for example. There you have an almost neurotic obsession with cleanliness, reflecting the guilt that comes with the last stages of capitalism. Or notice the unnecessary obsession of accumulation of glass in China and the compulsion to display it. Or look at the subtle hand of aggression with pistol handle knives.
I think I'll have to ask you to leave, Tony. I was going to ask you to stay for cocktails, but now I won't. Out. Out now. Vanishing culture, my eye. I've a mind to call your mother law. And you can tell that professor of yours at Amherst that I've got a mind to drive up there with this pistol handled knife in the seat beside me and cut off his anthropological ball.
Mother might want a drink.
She's reading to the children.
That's why she might want one.
She wants no such thing, Dad.
Then I want one.
Now? It's not even 5, Dad.
Well, then, let's go and see how the Red Sox are doing.
Daddy, stop.
Stop what?
Avoiding me. Ever since I've arrived, we haven't been able to talk.
Oh, what do you mean? Ever since you've arrived, it seems you've been talking continuously and simultaneously.
Alone, Daddy. Alone. You know I need alone.
All right. Right here in the dining room. Why not? As a matter of fact, I'm feeling rather tired. It's been a long day.
Oh, Daddy, I love this room. I've always loved this room.
Your mother and I still use it, now and then, once a week. Mrs. Robinson still comes in and cooks us a nice dinner, and we have it in here still. Lamb chops, lemons.
Daddy, I have a question.
Well, now, a little bit patient.
I'd love to permanently.
Permanent is a very long word.
Dad, I can't live with him. We just don't get along.
Well, you may think that now.
Dad, can you stay here?
Here?
For a few months.
With 3 small children.
Well, I'll work on my life, Dad, please.
Time is it? Little after 5. Seems to me the sun's over the yardarm. Or if it isn't, it should be. I think it's almost permissible for you and I to have a little drink.
All right.
I'll have scotch, sweetheart. Make it reasonably strong. And use the silver measuring gizmo in the drawer by the tray. I like 2 shots and a little water. And I like to use a large glass with the pheasant on it. And not too much ice. I saw Lily Mott the other day. There she was, with her 3rd husband, being a very good sport. Her 3rd, whose dad was a post and entirely disagreeable. So I took her aside and I said, now, Millie, if you made half as much effort with your 1st husband as you have with the last 2, don't you think you'd still be married to him? I asked her that point blank. You know what Millie said? She said, maybe. That's exactly what she said. Maybe, if she had made the effort.
Well, that's your generation, Dad.
It's every generation.
It's not mine.
Every generation has to make the effort.
Daddy, I want to be here.
I wanted the glass with the pheasant on it.
Well, I think the kids used it.
Oh,
so, Dad, can you stay here?
I sleep in your room now. Your mother kicked me out because I snore. Now we use the boys' room for watching TV.
Well, I'll sleep in the guest room.
And the children?
Well, they can sleep upstairs.
island. Well, your mother got wind of it and came down and told Betty Shoemaker to get on the first train out. And that was the end of it. Now, why don't you do that? Why don't you tell this woman to peddle her papers somewhere else?
I don't know. I simply don't know. I don't know whether to go in heaven or not.
room in the steam bath.
Oh, no.
What did you say, Dad?
Yeah, what did he say?
I believe I was speaking to your mother. Pinkie Pie made a remark, and apparently the new members in the club laughed. So poor Henry was so upset, he had to put on his clothes and leave. He called me from my house.
Oh, dear.
So I telephoned the club, and I spoke to several members, and they witnessed the incident. So I asked to speak to Pinkie Pies, and he refused to come to the phone. So I got to go do something about it.
Oh, dear.
So won't you tell us what he said to Uncle Henry, Dad?
I will not dignify the remark by repeating it.
Oh, come on, Dad. We're not babies.
Yes, Sam, just really.
He said, Claire, would you leave the room?
Bye. I'm older. She should know. Everybody should know. These are different times. Martha? We're not quite ready.
Yes, Mrs.
Now go on, Standish. Be funny for family.
Mr. Byers, you know, unfortunate remark having to do with your Uncle Henry's private life.
I'm afraid you're going to have to be more specific, dear.
Mr. Byers, who obviously been drinking all early afternoon, approached your Uncle Henry in the steam bath and alluded to direct terms to his personal relationships.
What personal
His association to the outside world.
I don't get it. You know, I don't get it.
Darling, apparently Mr. Byers must have made some unnecessary remark regarding your Uncle Henry's bachelor attachments.
You mean Uncle Henry is a fruit? Are you telling
me? I will
not
have that word in this house.
He got it from school, dear.
I don't care if he got it from God. I won't have that word in this house. My brother was wounded down in this club.
But what can you do, dear?
Go down there.
To your mother's?
To the club. Demand a public apology from the entire grill.
But if you won't even come to the telephone.
I have to find him.
Oh, Sandwich.
I have to.
Oh, Daddy.
I can't let that remark stand.
Can I come with you, Dad?
No, you stay here with your mother.
Oh, Sandwich, come on. Really? Vicky Byers is half your age and twice your size.
No arguments whatsoever.
He was on the wrestling team at Dartmouth.
It makes no difference.
What about your back shoulder? What about your hernia?
I know I might be seriously injured, but I can't stand idly by.
Oh, no, no, no.
The lamp will be overdone, Mrs.
And it's a beautiful lamp, Standish.
Listen to me, all of you. You too, brother. Now, there's nothing I'd rather do in this house than to sit down at this table with all of you and have some of Bertha's fine celery soup. About make a lamb with mint sauce and roast potatoes. Am I right about that mint sauce, Bertha?
Yes, sir.
So there's nothing I'd rather do than that. But I got to forego it. My father was publicly insulted down in his club, which means this family was insulted. And when the family's insulted, that means this table, these chairs, this room, and all of us in it, and you too, Bertha, have been treated with scorn. So if I stay here now, if I sat down here with all of you, I wouldn't be able to converse. I wouldn't be able to laugh. I wouldn't be able to correct your grandma, David. And I wouldn't be able to enjoy your fine meal, Bertha. I wouldn't be able to kiss my handsome wife goodbye. Goodbye, dear.
Goodbye, darling.
Goodbye, Winkins.
Goodbye, Daddy.
Goodbye, David.
So long, Dad.
Goodbye, Bertha.
Goodbye, sir. God bless you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Indeed.
Of course you can't eat now, Bertha. You find yourself something to eat.
Yes.
And the kids can raid the refrigerator on Sunday.
Yes.
David, you and I are going to go down to the club
okay.
and wait for the outcome of the visitor slot.
Okay.
Oh, David, so get a book. Get a good book.
Okay.
Get Ivan home. We could be quite a while. Claire, I want you to stay here and hold down the board, okay?
All right, Mother.
Oh, and get Dr. Russ on the telephone. I don't care if he's in the operating room. I don't care if he's having dinner. Tell him to meet us down at the club to get your father first aid.
All right, Mother.
Oh, and then study of French.
All right.
Okay?
Mother?
What now?
Is it true about Uncle Henry?
don't say it to him, you don't say it down at the club, and you definitely do not say it within a 10-mile radius of your father.
All right.
Now, goodbye.
We'll talk in here. No one will disturb us. No one comes near a dining room anymore. The thought of a number of people sitting down, eating good food, well cooked and properly served. That apparently doesn't occur to anybody these days. Nowadays, people eat in kitchens and in living rooms, standing around, balancing their plates like jugglers. Why? Pretty soon they'll be eating in bathrooms. But why not? Simplify the process considerably.
Down the place, Pop.
I'll sit here. We can look out of the window. There's a purple finch comes in the evening to feed its young. Now, I want to go to my funeral with you. Pop. I want to do it. There are only a few apples left in the barrel.
You've been saying that for years, Pop.
Well, this time it's true. So I want to go over this. You're my eldest son. I can't do it with anybody else. Your mother starts to cry, your brother isn't here, and your sister gets distracted. So concentrate, please, on my funeral.
Okay, Pop.
Now first, the obituary. For both newspapers. I dictated it to Miss Kovac down at the office. I've looked it over twice, and it's what I want. It's thorough without being self-concurrent, gratulatory. I mention my business career, my civic commitments, and of course my I even touch on my recreational life. I give my lowest scoring golf and the weight of the sailfish I caught off the keys. The papers will try to cut both items, but don't be ready.
Yes, Bob.
Next, I wanted to print this picture. It was taken when I was elected chair of the Symphony Drive. I think it will do. I don't look too young to die anymore, too old that it will make a
Okay, Bob.
Now, I want the funeral thing to be mentioned at the end of the obituary and to occur 3 days later. That will give people sufficient time to postpone their trips and adjust their equipment. And I want it to start at 3:30 in the afternoon. This will give people time to digest their lunch and will not obligate us to feed them dinner.
Mm.
Notice I have a little light in the wooden church. This is the fair where the maid tried to squeeze the service into the chapel, but no few left. I've lived in this town for a great many years, and I want everybody to find a seat and to feel comfortable. So if you can see people milling around the door, go right up to them and find them a place to sit, even if it's only a folding chair. Oh, will you be clear on that?
Yes, Bob.
Good. Now, I've listed the following works to be played by Mrs. Manchester at the organ. This Bach, this Handel, this Schubert. All lively, you'll notice. Nothing gloomy, nothing grim. But I'd like the service to start with a good rousing hymn. Onward, Christian soul. Then Mr. Fairweather may make some brief, underline brief, remarks about my life and work. Why don't you get up and speak for
me?
Yes. Do you plan to say anything?
I haven't thought about it.
Don't, if you don't want to. There's nothing more uncomfortable than an unwilling or reluctant speaker.
But
if, on the other hand, as my eldest son, you were to get your feet to say may have run away every summer, and you may live 1,000 miles away. You may be a terrible letter writer, but you love us all the same. You love me.
Yes, Bob. Oh, yes. Fine.
Now, at the graveside, just the fact, I want to be buried beside my brothers and just below my mother and father. And leave room for your mother to lie beside me. Even if she marries any prunes, she'll come back at the end.
Yes.
Invite people back after the funeral. Stay close to your mother. She gets uncomfortable in any kind of gathering and makes bad decisions. For example, don't let her serve a good Tanqueray gin if people just want to mix it with tonic water. And after they're gone, sit with her. Stay in the house with me for a few days. I love you, Father. And that's my funeral. I'm leaving you this room after your mother dies this table, chair, don't go with you. The best thing I can do is my father.
Thank you, Father.
Well, let's rejoin your mother. I'll put the envelope in my safe deposit box on top of the will and the stock certificates. The key will be in the left bureau drawer. Oh. You didn't see the purple finch feeding his young.
Yes, I did, Father.
You did? You saw it while I was talking?
That's right.
Good. I'm glad you saw it.
Remember, women's coats upstairs and men's coats in the home.
we've invited all of our favorite people. Now, I don't just mean all the people we've ever known. I mean all the people we've ever known.